Welcome to RyGurgul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about custom charts for Confluence. When you want to share important updates in Visual Graphics, definitely we'll need reports or charts to be integrated with our custom pages. To achieve this, reporting goals using pre-made charts templates, example Jira reports, Confluence reports, and start from scratch, we have to customize look and feel. Custom charts give us a peace and confidence by keeping our Confluence report data always up to date. Add rich text descriptor using the built-in editor or go stylist with all charts and reports available in dark mode. Even we can customize it according to our requirement. So we'll see here how we can add and create interactive custom charts and Confluence pages. So if you're not yet subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for further updates. And if you want to learn Jira with Agile as well as Jira REST API, maybe you can follow my Jira and Jira REST API playlist. I will also include the URL in my description tab so that it will be easy for you to refer it. Now, for adding custom charts, we have to just write custom, and you will see this add-ons are available. This is the add-ons available for the Confluence pages. Exactly same add-ons are also available for Jira as well. So in this, we'll majorly focus on custom charts for Confluence pages, which is built by OldSrit Solutions. If you want to know about more about OldSrit, simply go to their website, and from there you can follow the custom charts for Confluence, and you'll see here the exact descriptive man of the reports will be generated, which is helping us or making our life easy to showcase any data. Now, to add this, simply go here and click on try now, and if you want to have the license versions, you can add it. So as I said, this will be built by OldSrit Solutions. Post adding, you will see this custom charts will be added here. And the features of custom charts is more than 10 possible charts we can add it. That is one or two dimensions, which is pie, bar, funnel, line, or table. User impersonates features allows any Confluence user to view custom Jira charts with without the need of special permissions for a Jira account. Support for third-party app data, JSON request types, organizations, and channel. Custom GQL and self-save filter options for the more advanced user. Full range of customizations like custom ordering, color pickers, merge and rename value, and more stuffs we can do with Confluence custom charts. So to add this Confluence custom chart, simply we have to just press forward slash and write here custom. So here, if you want to add custom Jira report for issue list, we can add it from here. Otherwise, if you want to add or insert custom chart in the pages, we can also add this. Let's go ahead with this. When we are adding first time, it will ask us to load the chart. And post loading this chart, we will be able to use this custom charts available for our use. Now you can see this is asked for our permissions. Once we'll provide the permissions or granted permissions, we'll see here. First, that we have to add the project name, whichever project name you want to showcase, simply select it and click on search. So once we'll select on the search item, you'll see this all the issue lists are available in this item. And you can see here total 95 issues. If you want to give the title, so simply add here demo status. Now, even we can add the columns. If you want to modify the column name, we can add it from here. So now here issue types we have. If you want to add any more columns, we can also customize it. Click on insert and this chart will be generated as per our detail. Now at the end, if you want to customize this detail or create a issue list, you can also apply the filter. We can also apply add custom GQL toggle, and even for displaying, we can make this dark mode or light mode according to our requirement. Just save this, and the complete chart will become a darker. So here we can also do wider full width, and even we can remove it. Now we also have some other settings in this custom chart, like if you want to allow direct export to PNG and PDF, here we have allowed. If you don't want to allow the export options, we can just disable it. Even we can add show list bar, auto refresh every 10 minutes. If it is required to be refreshed in every 10 minutes, we can enable it. So after 10 minutes, the complete chart will be refreshed automatically. Display time dimensions and date in time fields is also possible. So if we want to display this time dimensions, we can also include it. Now here, descriptions are available at the bottom. Now show alternative rows columns, we can also showcase. If you want to showcase more than 10 in per pages, we can just add it, and this options will be visible. Now here, user imposed needs. So if custom charts will load data as per the user views and Confluence pages, if you want to allow with some other users, we can also allow it. In description tab, we can add descriptions about the chart, so that descriptions will be available at the bottom. Even if we want to make a bigger like documentations or user implementations, we can just click on this and we'll have the sections are available. In admin settings, when you click on the admin settings, it will navigate us to the admin portal where we can customize the default chart colors. So if you want to customize the color items, we'll simply check it out here, and as per our modification, the color code will be updated. App theme color, if you want to remove or set the app theme color, we can also make it customizable according to our requirement. Performance options, when we are setting up auto update for 10 minutes, it will automatically update after 10 minutes and the updated data available inside the charts. Even we can select the template options. User impressions are the allow Confluence users to view customer charts and Confluence pages. Features, these all features which is already enabled. And then data sources, which all data sources we have, we can see it from here. And if you want to do the cloud migrations, we have to just set it up accordingly. So this is how we can export it in PNG, PDF, and CSV file. Now, let me save this and I'll show you how to export it. Now, if you want to export this, then click on this, or otherwise we will just expand it. Now, if you want to generate some attractive custom charts, we can just type again custom charts Jira reports, and we'll see here attractive charts with the visuals are available. So again, select the project name. Let's select the project name again. This time we'll select this one as well. Click on search, and which chart types we want. So if you want the chart types as per the approval groups, approver, assignee, so simply we'll select this, and you'll see which all issue items are assigned and unassigned. Chart title, if you want to add chart title as assigned to. And now we will have this options are available. Even we can make a legend, which is auto legend positions, limit legend rows if you want, and we can calculate the chart percentage as well. Again, exactly same settings are available, which we have discussed as user impressions, chart descriptions, display options, and import and export feasibility. So if we are giving a copy to clipboard and other options, that will be available here. Now you can see here this chart is generated, which is very interactive impressions, like assigned to status. So 70% of issue is not yet assigned, just 30% of issue is assigned. Now if you want to create something else, like updating details or so with other fields, so we can also do it. Let's select by status. So If we are selecting by status, probably we will have these options are available. And again, we can change the color codes accordingly. So if you want to update the color codes, we can also do it just like selecting or picking the color codes to do. So if I want to keep the to do items at this color, I can set it up. If I want to just done status with the green color, so I will mark it with green color. So this is how we can customize our reports, and this reports will look like very interactive, which we can share with any of the people inside our organizations. If you want to add or keep inside this Jira page, Confluence pages, that is also fine. So that's all about custom charts in Confluence. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.